Hello everyone. Welcome to the 13th video of the Adobe After Effects tutorial from beginner to advanced. If you want to learn the After Effects software completely, please subscribe to my channel. In the previous lesson, you learned how to create different types of shapes. In this video, I will teach you how to create a gradient and blending mode for shapes. A gradient fill is a shape fill that gradually changes from one color to another across the surface of the shape. It can be one or a combination of several colors. So let's go ahead and make a gradient for the shape. I have already entered a photo as a background in After Effects. Now I draw a rectangle by clicking on the Shape Builder tool. By clicking on this rectangle in front of Fill, we can choose any color for this shape. I also choose a color for the stroke. With the Stroke Width tool and dragging, I increase the amount of stroke. Now we have to click on the Fill option to create a gradient. In the Fill Options window, if I click on the None option, the fill color will be completely hidden, and we can only see the stroke. By selecting the Solid Color option, the shape's color will be revealed. The next option is Linear Gradient, using which we can create a combination of two or more colors for the shape. The Radial Gradient option is similar to the Linear Gradient, with the difference that the transfer of colors is created from the center of the shape. In this window, we have access to the Opacity option to change the opacity of the shape, which can be increased or decreased by dragging. The lower the opacity value, the more visible the image below will be. From here we can change the blending mode of shape. But because we did not create another shape on this shape, no change was made. We will discuss this issue further. I select the option Linear Gradient and press the OK button. By default, black and white color is selected for the shape unless you have changed these colors before. Now if I click on the selection tool, two points will be created on the shape. By drawing these lines, we can determine the amount of color transfer and the direction of color transfer. If you hold down the Shift key while dragging one of these points, the point will move in a straight line. The farther these two points are from each other, the more gradually the color transfer is done. I put the points like this. Now I click on the rectangle facing fill to change the gradient color. This will open the gradient editor window. On both sides of the color transmitter, there are two color stops that we can change the desired color by clicking on each of them. I choose a blue color. Then I click on another color stop and choose red color. Now you can see the color transition from blue to red on the figure. We can choose any other color. Using color midpoint and dragging, we determine the amount of each color on the shape. In the location box, we can change the midpoint color value. If I place the mouse next to the midpoint, the shape of the mouse changes, and another color stop is created by clicking. In this way, we can create intermediate and more colors for the shape. For example, I choose the color green and adjust its location. For each color stop, there are two midpoints that determine the amount of color transfer. We can create as many color stops as we want for one shape. To delete a color stop, drag it down or click on it and hit the Delete button. I also use two opacity colors at the top to set the opacity value of each color. By clicking on this color opacity option, which is above the red color, the opacity option is activated. By dragging, I reduce the amount of opacity of the red color, and now by changing the opacity location, you can see the changes on the shape. This time, I change the location of the opacity of the blue color. You can see that because the opacity is 100% blue in the areas where there is blue, the image below is not visible. And you can see the image below only in the places where there is red color. We can change the opacity for both colors. I return the opacity of the colors to 100%. In addition to the linear gradient option, there is also the radial gradient option, which we said creates color transfer from the shape's center. But because I changed the location of the center point, now the center point is in the corner of the shape. I hit the OK button and with the selection tool, I place the color's center point in the shape's center. And with the other point, I adjust the amount of color transfer. I return to gradient editor again. Everything is exactly similar to a linear gradient, only the color transition starts from the center point. I'll add another color by clicking so you can see the changes on the shape. Because we are changing the gradient shape, you can see that in the settings of this layer, it automatically shows us gradient fill. We can also make changes through these options. I change the gradient a little with the selection tool. And again I choose a color for the shape. By clicking on the stroke option, the same settings as before are created, with the difference that the changes will be applied to the stroke of the shape. For example, I can hide or reveal the stroke or enable the gradient for the stroke. By changing the opacity value, I can increase or decrease the opacity of the stroke. I select the linear gradient option and press the OK button. Now, by clicking on the rectangle next to the stroke option, the gradient editor will be activated. I choose a red and green color for the gradient stroke and add another color. I hit the OK button. Now I determine the amount and direction of the colors with the selection tool and changing the location of the points. I click again on the stroke option and select a solid color to create only one color for the stroke. In the settings of the shape layer, I open the stroke option, and the same color, stroke, and stroke width options are available here that we can change. By right-clicking on any option and selecting Reset, the settings of that option will return to the default state. We can easily apply changes in the fill section. In front of each layer, there is a mode or blending mode option. If you don't see the mode option here, click on this icon to reveal the mode. Now we can choose different combinations and see their effect on the shape. By creating different colors for shapes, each of the blending mode options create different effects that are very useful in future projects that we will do. Be sure to apply different combinations so that you can choose the best combination. In the other settings of this layer, there is another option to select the mode, which does not make any changes in normal mode. But when we create several shapes in one layer and put them on top of each other, we can see the effect. So by selecting this layer I will create another rectangle and change its color. Now I change the rectangle mode. As a result, you can see the effect of the mode only in the areas where the shapes are overlapped. I will move the rectangle so that you can understand this better. Finally, pay attention to the fact that the mode options in this section affect all the shapes of this layer. But if you change the mode option from here, the effect of the mode will only be applied to this shape. Okay guys, thank you very much for watching this tutorial till the end. Please like the video and leave a comment for me. Subscribe to see more tutorials. I'll see you next time.